Hey there everybody, this just arrived. You can see I cut the package open already. Let's get it out of there. There it is. It is the SOG Ace. Fixed blade knife. It's got an anti-slip textured handle and includes the carry sheath. SOG Ace on it there. Neat looking little knife. And check out that sheath. It's got the designed by SOG, Seattle, Washington. It's got the skull with the beret. And I heard they sold these at Walmart for a while. It's got a stone washed blade. And they got a line cutter in the sheath, which when you stick the knife in, the blade shows down in there. So basically the knife blade is the line cutter. That's different. I gotta give them that. It includes the sheath, textured rubber handle. It is 8CR13 MOV, just like my Spyderco knife that I always carry. And like that little Amazon miniature kukri I recently reviewed. The blade length is almost 4 inches, 3.8. The weight is 4 ounces. Overall, it's almost 9 inches, 8.75. And the finish is stonewash. And I don't know if this is made in America or not. I think I heard SOG knives were, but yeah, I really don't know. If it was at Walmart, they're probably outsourcing it to China. But who knows? This is actually the first SOG knife I've ever owned. I don't know why, it just is, so let's get it open. Okay. Trying to do this without cutting my fingers off. Okay, there it is. Got a little plastic tip protector on it. I think that's more to protect people during shipping than it is to protect the blade. Try to get a little more light over here. It says SOG Ace. I don't know if you can see that very well. It's got a beautiful stonewashed, like bead blasted finish. Looks like there's some residue up there. It's oil. It's just oil. Doesn't say anything on this side. It's got a little drop point there. I don't think it's a clip point, it's more of a drop point. You might call it a clip point. I think it's a drop point. It's almost got a choil there. It does, you can get in there. It's got, it's like a saber grind, but it's high. See how high up that line is? It's almost a flat grind the whole way down. And then it has that little secondary micro bevel on it that's sharpened. It's got some kind of smooth jimping. Real big area too. About an inch and a half of jimping there. I'll let you see it from every angle. Yeah, it's weird. The handle feels kind of rubbery. It's like, it's firm like plastic, but it still has like a weird rubbery grippiness to it. You got a lanyard hole there. And there's, oh, that's cool. That's the skull with the beret. Spooky. That's pretty neat. It's got like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 finger grooves for people who have 9 fingers on one hand. Actually, that's just for grip, and it works really good. Feels good in the hand. It's like right to the back of my hand. And then see this little finger guard right here? It's like perfect. But I can choke up if I'm doing some fine carving, so that's cool. I don't know if that's going to strike a fire steel. maybe. I wouldn't push it. Even this area might not. Not every knife on earth has to strike a fire steel, though. Not everything's designed for bushcraft. There are matches and cigarette lighters and other ways to do things. But check that out. It says SOG on the handle. It's got a nice belt clip. That's would hold a good inch and a half belt, I think. It's very firm, too. So I don't think you're going to pull it out much. You can a little bit. It's actually pretty hard plastic. And that looks like it might slide out of there. I'm not even sure. But then it has their logo here, which we already saw. And then there's that like rope cutter cutout in the sheath. So let's put the knife in and see what that looks like. Okay, there's the blade going through. Okay, am I doing something wrong? Is that in all the way? Try that again. Okay, that's it. That little tiny click you heard was it locking in. Come on, focus. See that blade edge right there? Now you can use that to cut some paracord or something. And you don't have to worry about the blade edge being exposed because it is stainless steel, so it's not the end of the world if it gets a little water on it or something. It does have a weep hole there to drain out any water. It's pretty lightweight. Feels a little more handle heavy than blade heavy. Okay, here it is. Got a little chunk of paracord here. Let's see if that cord cutter there works. Got it in there. Yep, there it is. Cut the paracord just fine. It's a little weird feeling. It's like a seatbelt cutter. Never really used one of them before. And especially where it wasn't a razor and it was actually your knife blade as the seatbelt cutter. That was different. This feels somewhat sharp right out of the package. Let's see if it is. A sheet of printer paper here. Got the knife. Let's see how sharp it arrived. Yeah, that leaves a lot to be desired. It's not terrible. Needs to be sharpened and stropped a little bit. Okay, I'm back. Did about 10 strokes per side with the strop. Let's see if it helped anything. Yep. Yes, it did. It's not perfect, but it's way sharper. You can even get some of those rounded cuts. I bet you a few more seconds and it would be almost more sharp. See, it's a lot bigger than a 6-inch fire steel. Little plastic sheath, belt loop, pushes right off. It's got a bead blasted, like stone tumble finish on it, which looks really good. I think it's listed as full tang, but I think it's probably just a little stick tang down in there. So I wouldn't use this for super hard use. But in a pinch, it could be decent little protection. Just an everyday cutting knife on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the best. I'd probably give this one about a 4. Which isn't super awesome, but it's not terrible. Here it is beside a Mora bushcraft, I think it is, in stainless steel. This is a great sharp knife. And it's pretty thick. This here, I don't know if I can say it's really worth the money that they charge for it now. I'd say it might be worth about 10, 12 bucks. But they're asking about 29 bucks or so for it now, which I think is a touch overpriced, because it didn't arrive very sharp. The spine isn't very sharp. I don't know how great the tang is in it, but I know it sounds like I'm really knocking the knife, but it's not a terrible knife at all. And it is my first ever SOG knife, kind of an entry level Walmart, Wally World entry level SOG. But it's cool. I'll do a couple other knife comparisons real quick. Okay, there it is beside a Glock 81 field knife. Here it is beside an Ontario Blackbird SK5. Here it is beside Tank, my BK two companion knife, which I modified. Well, this is just a little like entry level SOG knife, and it's interesting. It's a cool little knife. I'm glad I picked it up. I know you can also get them that they have a black handle and a digital camouflage sheath, but I just went for the all black. I figured it looked a little more stealthy, but that's just my opinion. Pretty neat. I'm glad I got it. Well, that's all I have for this knife. This is Joe Doomsday signing out.